And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. We've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the Seattle Mariners. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. Plenty of storylines taking shape in this series as we set the stage for game four, Chris.
Well, if the first three games are any indication, this has the look of a series that'll go all the way to game seven, Boog. I think this is a classic matchup, and we've seen momentum change course a few times already, but I'll tell you what, I think whoever takes this one will be feeling really good about their chances the rest of the way.
Yeah, that's a good point. We've seen it before. Even when you're down 2-1, it seems like a win in game four can propel you to a series win more often than not. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about ready to roll. And on the mound today, Robbie Ray. What do you have on him, Chris?
A very forgettable start his last time out. Was only able to work a couple of innings. We're looking for him to put it all together today. Command, tempo, and just really a confident presence out there on the mound.
So just about set now. And stepping in for the Rays, Brandon Lau. And a 1-1. There's a swing and a drive. Back there. Brandon Lau goes the other way with it. His second homer of this series. It's 1-0.
Well, we see this so much more today. Lineups with pop in the leadoff spot, and it really puts the pitcher in a tough spot out there where he has to execute right away. You can't just get over a couple of strikes to settle in, get comfortable, because at the plate, that guy's looking to do exactly what he just did. Start the game off with a huge bang.
Here's Wander Franco. Next offering is in for a strike.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
Nobody on, nobody out. The Rays leading on the solo homer. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Austin Meadows down.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
One down, base is empty. Foul ball there.
I think it's huge that they were able to score right away. You're playing on the road. Stakes are high. Energy in the ballpark. And you help to quiet that down a little bit.
Swing and a miss. And he chases that one in the dirt. Out on the drop third strike. Two gone. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Comes up empty, that's strike two. Here comes a pitch. Out to short. Crawford throws to first in time. They get the out on Arozarena. And that'll do it. And the Rays get one on a solo shot. It's an early 1-0 lead. Bottom of the first. And starting this one is Drew Rasmussen.
Just a four-inning start his last time out. He took the loss. They're looking for more out of this guy today.
We go to the bottom of the first. And now for Seattle, Adam Frazier. And a pitch. Swing and a miss.
Well, you got to find a way to catch up to that pitch. Perhaps shorten the swing, eliminate the stride. That one came in hot, but right down the middle, you're saying to yourself, how did I miss that pitch? Got to make a quick adjustment.
Gathers and throws to first. One gone, bottom half of the first.
Batting second, the first baseman.
So up next, Ty France. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes and two away now. Here's Jesse Winker.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to take that right back up the middle approach.
Has some trouble with it, but he wins the foot race to first. Good job of knowing how much time he had there. Mariners go down quietly there, and it remains 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, and now G-Man Choi. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count is even, 2-2. And that just misses. Gary Simmons has the plate duty in this one.
Well, with Simmons, it's not always your standard strike zone boog. It kind of gives a little extra in some parts of the zone and then can be tighter in others. But I think the important thing is he doesn't get labeled as inconsistent. So you got to stay ready up there.
Yeah, one of those umpires, you just have to know what to expect, right?
Exactly.
Line drive and a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
All over that one right there. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're right where you want to be with your swing mechanics.
Yandy Diaz now. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And there's one away. Manuel Margot up to the plate. The pitch. And that's ball four.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Here's Mike Zunino. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Choi, the lead runner out at second. Margot at first. One gone. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Clearly hoping he could get a swing and miss on that, but doesn't fool the hitter with that breaking ball. Nice job, just couldn't keep it fair.
Sneaks through, base hit. And they stop him at third, so base is loaded with one away. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
Here's Kiermaier now. And the pitch. That's in there. That's strike two.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
On the ground, could be two. Off-balance feed, there's one. Throw to first, but he beat it.
I promise you, they're guys that get a little bit faster when they can smell an RBI. That was a possible inning-ending double play. Great hustle, and he gets rewarded with the RBI because of it.
And now it's Brandon Lau. Left-hand hitter waits. Got him. Good job at damage control right there. Now to the bottom of the second. It's the Rays 2 and the Mariners nothing. Back at T-Mobile Park, now batting Mitch Haniger. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say. And the righty deals. And he hits a ground ball right side. The flip to the pitcher covering, and they take care of Haniger for the out.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what he was supposed to do.
And Eugenio Suarez up to hit now.
Well, he's a good player, but if he wants to be great, he's going to have to figure it out against right-handed pitchers. There's so many right-handers in the game that you're going to see them one after another. So you would imagine with that many looks, Boog, that the adjustment's got to be coming soon.
Throw over to Choi, and a couple of quick outs.
Deceptive slider right there, stayed in the tunnel a long time, got that hitter out front, rolled over it, put it on the ground.
J.P. Crawford.
Now the batter now, J.P. Crawford. And the right-hander deals. That's hard hit in the line. Diving, makes the grab.
One of the most fun and exciting things you could do as an outfielder, you lay out, you make a diving catch, and you end the inning. That gets the boys fired up in the dugout.
Welcome back. New inning getting started. Now batting Wander Franco. A wind and a pitch. That one the other way. Frazier on the first in time. And a quick out number one.
Now that is designated hit. Austin Meadows.
Now at the plate, Austin Meadows. 0 for 1 so far. The 1-1.
That's 4. I got 2-1 the count.
On the ground, Suarez collects, fires to first on the run. Score at 5-3 for the second out with the third baseman shifted over there. Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. Grounded out his first time up. The 2-1. Swing and a foul back, that's out of play. The pitch, and that one fouled off. The 2-2 on the ground right side, and he can't come up with it, and he'll be safe at first. So two down, and now the hitter G-Man Choi. Next offering is in for a strike. Kicks and fires. Arozarena on the move. Pitch misses. Throw to second. Out there. And that ends the inning.
Well, trying to get into scoring position, but a great catch and throw to end the inning. That's the way to pick up the pitcher.
And welcome back. Here's the center fielder, Kyle Lewis. And 1-2.
Just completely fooled on the breaking ball right there. Had no chance.
and here comes.
And another ball.
Really good slider. He's up there just hoping that it ends up off the plate away.
Hit pretty well in the air out to center. He's got it,
and there's one down.
Batting it. No left fielder.
Here's Jared Kelnick. And a pitch.
So now 1-2.
Spin rate's outstanding on that high fastball. Really tough to hit.
And now it's 1-2. Stays alive. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out.
Out number two. Stayed with the fastball on all three pitches to put him away.
Yeah, just straight attacked him. And those locations of the fastball is what really stood out to me, Boog. Started him inside, really good location. Then he went away for strike two, going kind of east-west, and then finishes him off up in the zone with some good velocity. That's just great execution.
So here's Murphy now.
Next pitch, not close, up high. Ripped on a line to center.
Kiermaier makes the catch, and that'll do it. And 1-2-3 go to Mariners. They trail it here 2-0.
Back in Seattle,
and here's the first baseman, G-Man Choi. Pitch. Strike two.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
France collects it. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. That's the first out in the top of the fourth.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
Down the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. Here's a 1-1. Swing and a ball popped up. Pulls it down and there's two gone. The right fielder, so two down now, and here is Manuel Margot. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. Two outs. Fouled off. He was late. Center field, Lewis drifts towards it, puts the squeeze on it, and that is the third out of the inning. Rays held in check here as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Back here at the ballpark, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton with you, and leading off the bottom of the fourth, Adam Frazier. The other way, hauls it in, and there's one away.
The first baseman, number 23, Tom France.
And now the first baseman, Ty France. His first at bat was a strikeout. The Mariners yet to pick up a hit here.
And it's even up.
When you throw a fastball by a guy like that, I imagine it's got to feel incredible. Look for him to throw it again at some point.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That one ripped. And now maybe extra bases. And that's going to get into the corner. Margot throws to second. And he's got a double.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
One down. Jesse Winker now at the plate. Payoff pitch. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That one's deep. And it's gone. Home run. A two-run homer. And this game is tied. It's 2-2.
That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Mitch Haniger. Next pitch misses way outside. Still only one out here in the inning. Next pitch is outside.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Now front pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. And a pitch. Got him. Two gone.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those. More margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport, and I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
Two outs, bases empty. Eugenio Suarez digs in now. The next pitch misses. Now two balls and a strike. Next offering is foul back. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Two come in on this Seattle homer. And we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Back at T-Mobile Park, here's a big power threat. Mike Zunino.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
Here's a 1-1. And there's a foul ball. And now it's even up. And now it's filled up. 3-2 now. And down on strikes he goes. And that's the first out.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. They tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
The 2-1. Swings and lines a base hit into left field.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
So the batting order turns over. Lau at the plate. Ray throw to first. Kiermaier back in. And the next pitch is way outside. Kiermaier, the runner at first with one gone in the inning.
He's going, he's
Kiermaier
going.
On the go. Pitch in the dirt. Throw to second. Ow!
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw. Quick, not rushed, and accurate.
Left-hand batter waits. And now the count filled up 3-2.
Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Payoff pitch. On the ground, right side. He handles it himself, and that'll do it. Halfway through, and we're tied 2 apiece. Bottom of the inning, and stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford. The 3-1. Now a screamer into the outfield. And it one-hops the wall. Throws to second. And that's a leadoff double. This is Kyle Lewis.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion. And he's in full speed.
No outs. Runner on second. And ball four to aboard.
Well, he took his chance at getting him to chase right there. But with first base open, walk not a bad thing. He set up a double play opportunity if he can induce a ground ball.
Jared Kelnick up next for the Mariners.
And Boog, I'd say he's due.
The 1-1. Hit on the ground, might be two. Over to Lau. On to Choi. Double play.
The catcher, number two, John Murphy.
Now the Mariners' catcher, Tom Murphy. He's 0-1.
Well, there's a reason why he's at the bottom of the order, struggling as of late, but a knock here would be a huge lift for him and for his team.
In the air, right field, and an automatic double as it hops the fence as a run scores.
He puts a great swing on that pitch and drives home the run, and that was always going to be a double, but the bounce over the wall just took the guesswork out of it right away. It was a nice swing.
Here's Adam Frazier. Runner leads away at second. Left field. Oh, and he whiffs on it. Knocks it down to the hole.
Well, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
And up next for Seattle, Ty France.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
New pitcher on now, Josh Fleming. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Frazier at second. France on at first with two down. Next offering is fouled back.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, or maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
And he makes the catch. And the inning is over. We're through five. It's the Mariners 4, the Rays 2. All set for the start of the inning. Now the number 2 hitter, Wander Franco. Pitch. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. Way inside, gets out of the way. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And that lands in no man's land, a foul ball. 2-2 now. That one hammered center field. That's got a chance. Hauls it in on the warning track. Now it's Austin Meadows. One down. Just missed. Well struck, right field. Banks off the wall. The throw into second. And he's there with a double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. The 2-1. And that one off the outside edge. Runner at second here, one gone. And now a full count. Activity in the bullpen. Sergio Romo up and throwing. Bisevich, the lefty, warming up as well. And he deals. Got him looking. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, you got to be ready to swing the bat with a runner in scoring position and two strikes. Just put the ball in play somewhere, and you got a chance. Very frustrating for him, I'm sure. See if the next guy can pick him up.
G-Man Choi next to hit for the Rays. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Kicks and deals. That one to first. France takes it himself, and the inning is over. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4-5-6 coming up. It's the Mariners 4, the Rays 2. Bottom of the sixth, and here is Mitch Haniger. Big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And a count 1-2.
swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Man aboard on the leadoff single. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And a pitch. He swings and fouls one off. On the ground, out to short. Lays out, but he can't squeeze it. Not in time. He's safe.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
So digging in, J.P. Crawford. And a pitch. And a good eye there.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
And now the lefty. Here's the pitch. It's a double steal. Swing and a miss. And the throw. He's out at third. Left-hand hitter waits. Up the middle. Franco on to first. He's out.
Up next to Seattle, the center fielder, Kyle Lewis.
Kyle Lewis up next for the Mariners.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
Two outs and one in scoring position. Next pitch in the dirt. Ball two. Bullpen movement for the Rays. Brooks Raley up and loosening in the pen. Springs getting cranked up as well. And a 2-1 on the way. Out to short. Throw over to Choi, and that ends the inning. One left for Seattle as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
Next offering way off the plate.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it. Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
And here comes the Mariners manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. That'll do it for Robbie Ray. Two-run ball game as he heads for the dugout, and we'll be back with a new pitcher. Sergio Romo taking over on the mound.
Number 54, Sergio Romo.
Here's Manuel Margot. Diaz aboard here at first with nobody out. And now 2-1 after that missed inside.
Well, now that this is a bullpen game, it's clear that whichever bullpen steps up the most is likely going to come away with the W.
Swing and a miss. That is strike two. Friday to the plate. Not even close there. Full count, 3-2. Right through there, got him. Now one away. Mike Zunino, next to hit for the Rays. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. The tying run at the plate. The punch out there, that's out number two.
Well, that right there is just a pitcher's pitch, tailing away from the hitter, low and away with some good action at the end. You know, even if he gets the bat to that ball, it's probably just a weak ground ball to the opposite side. Tell you what, that's a tremendous two-strike pitch.
So up next, Kevin Kiermaier.
Pretty amazing going way back. Possibly the best center fielder I've ever seen.
Next pitch is outside. Tying run at the plate. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. The 2-2. Swung on, belted. That one's carrying. Pulls it in on the warning track. The Rays strand just the one. Still down by a count of 4-2. Pitching change here, Brooks Raley. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Number 30, Brooks. So digging in, Jared Kelnick. Kicks and fires. And fouled off. Pitch. And yeah, that's outside.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now one away. Now it's Tom Murphy.
The catcher. Tom Murphy.
Next offering upstairs. And the pitch. And a swing and a miss. Back-to-back strikeouts.
Chance to strike out the side now. You talk about the benefits, the advantages of relievers who can come in and get the swing and miss, whether it's inherited runners or maybe a little jam that they get into themselves. Knowing that they can miss the bat, tell you what, that's huge and can change the ballgame.
Back to the top of the lineup. Next to hit, Adam Frazier. 1-3. Hit on the ground to the right side. Slides, but it gets by him.
Well, that was one of those high percentage advantage counts where batting averages are just so much higher. Just one of those seen eye base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you enough.
Ty France up next for the Mariners. Two outs. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. Frazier around third. He'll score. It's 5-2.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one, ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
Jesse Winker stands in with two away as he takes a ball. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Next offering is foul back. France stands at second with two gone. And that one fouled off. Next one misses, 3-2 now. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, he earned his trip to first right there. It's not easy laying off pitches that just missed the zone like that. And it's a real discipline as well. He's put a lot of work into that aspect of his game, and it paid off right there.
New pitcher now, Matt Whistler. And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Mitch Haniger.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Two outs, a couple of base runners at first and second. Swing and a miss, and that is that. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's 5-2. Now on the bump, Diego Castillo. He's into the game to face his former team. Three, two now. Got him looking. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Wander Franco next to hit for the Rays. But why to kick the pitch? Little chopper rolls foul. The line of the pitch. And now 2-2. And that one hammered. That's back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. He circles the bases, and they inch closer. It's 5-3.
Oh, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. We saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news, and all of a sudden they're back in this ball game.
Here is Austin Meadows. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. Bounced up the middle. Throw off line, he's safe, and a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
That's a play you expect your shortstop to make pretty much every time. Pretty routine. Hard to tell if he didn't get a great grip on it or the mechanics on him just broke down, but that gives this offense an extra out to work with.
Randy or Rosarena the next to hit. The pitch. Oh.
I don't know how you take that.
That was a strike. The pitch. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum. Very quickly, they're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
G-Man Choi getting ready to hit.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Runners at first and second with one gone. Next pitch is outside.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Next offering misses, and now 3-1.
Lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
To short, could be two. Crawford tossed the second. What a double play that was. Inning over. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now 5-3. Ready for the bottom of the eighth. And now for Seattle, Eugenio Suarez. The 1-1. That one fouled off. Swing and a miss, and he got him. And one out now.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
J.P. Crawford up next for the Mariners. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Two away. Two outs, bases empty. And stepping in for the Mariners, Kyle Lewis. The 1-1. And a foul ball. The 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nobody left for Seattle. And it remains 5-3. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Paul Sewald.
Number 37, Paul.
And welcome back. All set to start the ninth in this one. Now the third baseman, Yandy Diaz. Falling behind 2-1. Sewald, he's known as a reliever that excels in really tough situations. Those high leverage spots, it seems like he's at his best in these situations. And obviously the ability to get the strikeout factors in. Swings and misses. And the count is 2-2.
Yeah, there are certain guys that expect to come in and dominate, and they see the challenge, the battle, just a little bit differently. They trust their stuff, and they believe that their stuff is better than that guy standing in the batter's box, what his swing, what his ability is.
Well, the first batter, it's always a big one for the closer. I mean, you get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're going to wrap this thing up.
Next pitch is popped up. Frazier makes the play.
And there's two away.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
The mental approach is a big factor too, isn't it?
Yeah, Boog, it is. And, you know, for each guy, it can be a little different. Some people consciously work on focusing, slowing things down, breathing techniques. And then there's some players that are just natural, and they just seem to be more composed and less excitable.
Ball to strike.
And a foul ball. A lot of times with relievers, they just like to get amped up, and they're not really looking to try and slow it down, right? They're just trying to get hyper.
Yeah, and perhaps make that.
And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, this was a huge win for these guys. Instead of 2-2 in the series, they're comfortably now 3-1. One more win, and they take the series.
Final look at the line score from this one, Chris.
It was a close two-run game, and a couple of key moments just really made the difference. Not much separates these two teams.
A 5-3 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew, I'm John Ciambi saying so long from T-Mobile Park in Seattle.
First was a victorious Seattle Mariners. 5 runs on 9 hits. 1 error. They left 5 men on base. For the Rays, 3 runs on 7 hits. No errors. They left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 4 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at T-Mobile Park, 47,715. The Mariners thank you for your patronage and remind you to please buckle up and drive home safely.